Nairobi, we went on a day trip to Hell's Gate National Park and Crescent Island Game Sanctuary. The sanctuary was used for filming parts of the movie Out of Africa, and some say that the movie placed most of the wild animals on the island. There are no vehicles on the island, so walking is the only way to get around. No predators animals allowed. Giraffe, zebra, hippo, gazelle, birds, and wildebeest only. We also did a half-day game drive in Nairobi National Park. The next stop, a small bush plane from Nairobi to an airstrip in the Maasai Mara Conservancy. A fly-in safari. 3 nights at the Matera Bush Camp in deluxe tents and multiple game drives. Our camp was very close to the Mara River. Another bush plane back to Nairobi. From Nairobi, a bush plane down to Amboseli National Park airstrip. The plane had to circle around once before landing. Zebra were on the one dirt runway. Setau LRA bush camp in deluxe tents and 3 days of game drives. Overland from Amboseli through a remote border crossing into Tanzania. An overnight stay in Arusha, before heading to Tarangire River Camp and the Tarangire National Park for 1.5 days of game drives. Then off to Lake Manyara National Park for an all-day game drive and the farmhouse lodging by Ngorongoro Crater. A full day of game drives in the crater, followed the next day by a bush plane to the northern Serengeti and the Lamalamara mobile tent at camp for 5 nights. Multiple game drives and a hot air balloon safari over the Serengeti. From the northern Serengeti, another bush plane to the border of Tanzania and Kenya. A van to the border crossing customs and then another bush plane to the Maasai Mara and Sentinel Mara tented camp. Back to Nairobi via another bush plane and then off to Rwanda for guerrilla trekking. Matera Mara tented camp is near the Mara River and Maasai Mara, Kenya. A nice camp with a view of the savanna from our tent and just a quarter of a mile from where lion pride would sleep at night. Setau LRA is a tented camp just outside of Amboseli National Park. We had great views of Mount Kilimanjaro from our front porch. A watering hole by the main lodge was frequently visited by elephant, giraffe, zebra, gazelle, and warthogs. Tarangire River Camp was just outside of Tarangire National Park. The camp was right along a dry river bed, which was frequented by elephant. The Ngorongoro farmhouse was more of a luxury lodge with cabins. We had great views of Ngorongoro Crater from the lodge and our cabin. Lamalamara mobile tented camp moves with the migration. It was located right near the Mara River, providing us numerous access to the Mara River and wildebeest migrations. At night prior to dinner, we would all gather around a fire pit and have drinks and appetizers, while watching the sunset. Sentinel Mara Camp was right on the Mara River. Every tent and the main tents were along the river, with great views of the crocs and hippos. Birds chirping, hippos doing what they do, would be our background noise. Everyone would gather around a fire at night, having a drink and eating popcorn, prior to dinner. We even had one night with Sheila and Ron being the only two in camp. The Great Migration is considered a continuous movement of the wildebeest and zebras in an ongoing search for water and food. Over 1.5 million blue wildebeest, 200,000 zebra, and gazelles are continually in search for water and food across 150,000 square miles of wilderness, plains, and woodlands, which include the Serengeti National Park in Tanzania and Maasai Mara Game Reserve in Kenya. As food and water sources dry up in southern Serengeti, the migration continues north in search of water and food, eventually circling back down to the southern Serengeti. An endless circle in search for food and water. This map of the northern Serengeti in Tanzania and Maasai Mara in Kenya contains yellow markers along the Mara River. For each location, we watched the Mara River crossing and the number of pictures we took. By the time we arrived at this Mara River crossing, the first wave of wildebeest were just completing their migration to our side of the Mara River. Then another small herd of wildebeest started to cross. The Karaks were alerted and missed the first herd, but not this one. This was the smallest and quickest migration we saw, but the most eventful, with multiple Karak attacks on the wildebeest as they crossed. Unfortunately for the Karak, no wildebeest lost their life on this crossing. We got some great video and pictures of the Karak attack. This was one of the largest migrations we saw. It lasted for around 20 minutes, and when it was done, some of the wildebeest and zebra were still on our side. We didn't see any croc attacks, but there was a lot of activity and could have been. We estimated at least 40 land cruisers on the other side of the river. Our side was less crowded. Our guide driver got us a great spot along the Mara River to watch. This crossing was notable as having a battle between a wildebeest and cross that lasted for around 15 minutes. The wildebeest eventually escaped with injuries and limping. Another cross starts swimming toward the wildebeest and joins in on the attack. Wildebeest, exhausted, but free from the cross and limping away from the Mara River. This crossing was in Masai Mara and near Sentinel Mara Camp. It was notable as a non-crossing and the most chaotic non-crossing. The wildebeest started heading down to the Mara River to cross, but some aggressive land cruiser drivers on the other side of the river spooked them. As a result, the wildebeest made a mad dash along the Mara River, which ended at a dead end, unless they crossed. Instead of crossing, they made another mad dash back the way they came and heading away from the embankment. They switched direction again. Then they started jumping off the cliff down to the embankment. It was total chaos and dust. After about 20 minutes of this, they eventually all went back up the embankment to migrate another day. Leopards. While leopards can be found in all the parks we visited, all our encounters were in the northern Serengeti in Tanzania and the Masai Mara in Kenya, with the Masai Mara having the best encounters. This map shows where we took pictures of the leopards in both areas. The leopard is the smallest and most dangerous of the big cats. Leopards use trees as the perfect escape point from predators and to get the best vantage point. Leopards often hide large kills in trees, requiring great strength. They prefer eating in trees and leaving their food for the next meal, safe from lions, hyenas and other predators. Leopards are well known for their strength, which allows them to carry a prey 2 times bigger than them to the top of a tree. They live in wooded savannas and rocky parts of the reserve, so they can easily hunt prey with their great hunting and climbing skills. A leopard resting in a tree saw potential prey, climbed down and walked by our Land Cruiser while stalking its prey. Ultimately, the leopard was not successful. A leopard taking a nap after killing an impala and dragging it up a tree. Cheetah. We came across this family of 4 cheetah, and along with around 14 other Land Cruisers, we followed them as they hunted prey. The following video and pictures show these four cheetahs as they cross the plains in search of a meal and unsuccessfully chased a topi. Enjoy the journey. The cheetah is the world's fastest land mammal. With acceleration that would leave most automobiles in the dust, a cheetah can go from 0 to 60 miles an hour in only 3 seconds. These big cats are quite nimble at high speed and can make quick and sudden turns in pursuit of prey. Cheetahs have several special adaptations that allow them to reach top speeds. Wide nostrils and large lungs combined with a powerful heart and strong arteries provide more oxygen to their muscles. Their huge leg muscles mainly consist of fast twitch fibers, which contract faster than normal muscles. Their small body frame is lightweight and aerodynamic. With long legs, loose hip and shoulder joints, and a flexible spine, cheetahs can cover 25 feet in one stride. Running this quickly takes a lot of energy, and cheetahs can only maintain the sprint for about half a minute before burning out. With this limiting factor, they try to get as close as possible to their prey, which include antelope, wildebeest calves, and hares, before starting the chase. Camouflaged against the tall grasses, they quietly sneak up until they are confident of the attack. They burst out, using their tail as a rudder to help keep balance while making sharp turns. Their claws, which do not fully retract, grip the ground like cleats. Once they reach their target, they use their front paw to trip the prey. Then they strangle the animal with a bite and drag it to a hiding spot before another predator, such as a lion, leopard, or hyena, steals it. Today, around 7,500 cheetahs live in the wild. Cheetahs are threatened by habitat loss and conflicts with farmers. While lions can be found in all the parks we visited, all our encounters were in the northern Serengeti in Tanzania and the Masai Mara in Kenya. This map shows where we took pictures of the lions in both areas. Lions. Lions are the only cats that live in groups of 5 to 25, which are called prides. Prides are family units that may include up to 3 males, a dozen or so females, and their young. All of a pride's lionesses are related, and female cubs typically stay with the group as they age. Young males eventually leave and establish their own prides by taking over a group headed by another male. Only male lions boast manes, the impressive fringe of long hair that encircles their heads. Males defend the pride's territory, which may include some 100 square miles of grasslands, scrub, or open woodlands. These intimidating animals mark the area with urine, roar menacingly to warn intruders, and chase off animals that encroach on their turf. An adult male African lion is over 400 pounds and 4 feet tall at the shoulder. They are equipped with enormous fangs and incredibly powerful necks, forelimbs and claws that allow them to hunt, on average, the largest prey of any land animal. Many adult male lions, however, live alone or in small bachelor groups. not bold enough or strong enough to take on established males. And pride leaders themselves, worn down from constant battles, will eventually succumb to a stronger rivals and retreat back to a solitary lifestyle. Female lions are the pride's primary hunters. They often work together to prey upon antelopes, zebras, wildebeest, and other large animals of the open grasslands, sometimes with the help of an adult male. Many of these animals are faster than lions, so teamwork pays off. Regularly taking down 600-pound plains zebras and 1,300-pound Cape buffalo, African lions will also take on giraffes and even elephants in the right situation. After the hunt, the adult males, generally 30-40% larger, eat first. The group effort often degenerates to squabbling over the sharing of the kill, with cubs at the bottom of the pecking order. Young lions do not help to hunt until they are about a year old. Lions will hunt alone if the opportunity presents itself, and they also steal kills from hyenas or wild dogs. African lions roam the grasslands and vast savannas of Central and South Africa. These videos and pictures show several lions dining on meals, soon after the kill. These female lions are part of the same pride and greeted each other like they haven't seen each other in years. This lion and lioness are mating. When in heat, they will mate every 15 minutes for a 24-hour period. Note the expressions on both lions. Kwitazina is Rwanda's annual week-long celebration in the first week of September, where they give baby mountain gorillas a unique name. It is a symbol of Rwanda's success in conservation. This wicker gorilla is rebuilt each year for the celebration. Our guide drove an hour to meet a tracker at the base of Mount Kurasumbi, in the Virunga mountain range. We hired porters to carry our backpacks and proceeded to hike with a tracker and guide for 2 miles to an elevation of 10,070. Our elevation gain was 1,221 feet. We hiked through rainforest, vines, bamboo, and mud. Finally, after 2 hours of hiking, we reached the Isimbi gorilla group of 20 gorillas, including one silverback. Mountain gorilla. There are only several hundred mountain gorillas remaining on Earth, and about half live in the forests of the Virunga Mountains in Rwanda. These gorillas live on the green, volcanic slopes of Rwanda, Uganda, and the Democratic Republic of Congo, areas that have seen much human violence from which the gorillas have not escaped unscathed. Mountain gorillas have longer hair and shorter arms than their lowland cousins. They also tend to be a bit larger than other gorillas. Gorillas can climb trees, but are usually found on the ground in communities of up to 30 individuals. These troops are organized according to fascinating social structures. Troops are led by one dominant, older adult male, often called a silverback because of the swath of silver hair that adorns his otherwise dark fur. Troops also include several other young males, some females, and their offspring. The leader organizes troop activities like eating, nesting in leaves, and moving about the group's 0.75 to 16 square mile home range. Those who challenge this alpha male are apt to be cowed by impressive shows of physical power. He may stand upright, throw things, make aggressive charges, and pound his huge chest while barking out powerful hoots or unleashing a frightening roar. Despite these displays and the animal's obvious physical power, gorillas are generally calm and non-aggressive unless they are disturbed. In the thick forests of Central and West Africa, troops find plentiful food for their vegetarian diet. They eat roots, shoots, fruit, wild celery, and tree bark and pulp. Female gorillas give birth to one infant after a pregnancy of nearly 9 months. Unlike their powerful parents, newborns are tiny, weighing 4 pounds, and able only to cling to their mother's fur. These infants ride on their mother's backs from the age of 4 months through the first 2 or 3 years of their lives. Young gorillas, from 3 to 6 years old, remind human observers of children. Much of their day is spent in play, climbing trees, chasing one another, and swinging from branches.
Sort of showing off a bit.
He wanted to have that food, and those are vines that put them down.
Wildebeest. The wildebeest earned the Afrikaans name wildebeest, or wild beast, for the menacing appearance presented by its large head, shaggy mane, pointed beard, and sharp, curved horns. The blue wildebeest is a member of the antelope family, although its heavy build and disproportionately large free quarters make it look more bovine. Blue wildebeest can reach 8 feet in length, stand 4.5 feet tall at the shoulders, and weigh up to 600 pounds. Both males and females grow horns. Their habitat comprises the grassy plains and open woodlands of central, southern, and eastern Africa, particularly the Serengeti in Tanzania and Kenya. They travel in large herds and are active day and night, grazing constantly. Their spectacular northward migration in search of greener pastures and water is considered one of the greatest wildlife spectacles on Earth. Involving up to 1.5 million wildebeests as well as hundreds of thousands of other animals, including zebra and gazelle. Giraffes. Giraffes are the world's tallest mammals, thanks to their towering legs and long necks. These long legs allow giraffes to run as fast as 35 miles an hour over short distances and cruise comfortably at 10 miles an hour over longer distances. Typically, these fascinating animals roam the open grasslands in small groups of about half a dozen. Bulls sometimes battle one another by butting their long necks and heads. Such contests aren't usually dangerous and end when one animal submits and walks away. Giraffes use their height to good advantage and browse on leaves and buds in treetops that few other animals can. Even the giraffe's tongue is long. The 21-inch tongue helps them pluck tasty morsels from branches. Giraffes eat most of the time and, like cows, regurgitate food and chew it as cud. A giraffe eats hundreds of pounds of leaves each week and must travel miles to find enough food. The giraffe's height also helps it to keep a sharp lookout for predators across the wide expanse of the African savanna. The giraffe's stature can be a disadvantage as well. It is difficult and dangerous for a giraffe to drink at a water hole. To do so, they must spread their legs and bend down in an awkward position that makes them vulnerable to predators like Africa's big cats. Giraffes only need to drink once every several days. They get most of their water from the luscious plants they eat. Female giraffes give birth standing up. Their young endure a rather rude welcome into the world by falling more than 5 feet to the ground at birth. These infants can stand in half an hour and run with their mothers an incredible 10 hours after birth. Giraffes have beautiful spotted coats. While no two individuals have exactly the same pattern, giraffes from the same area appear similar. Up until recently, the consensus has been there is only one species of giraffe with multiple subspecies. In 2016, some scientists released a study that claims genetic differences among giraffe populations indicate the existence of 4 distinct giraffe species. The giraffe and the yellow-billed oxpecker have a mutually beneficial relationship. The yellow-billed oxpecker are perching birds with feet adapted for grasping, which allow them to ride on a host while looking for a meal. They sift through the host's hair looking for insects, but their first preference is for blood-swollen mature female ticks. This female giraffe is very pregnant. Elephants. African elephants are the largest land animals on Earth. They have large ears that look somewhat like the continent of Africa. Elephant ears radiate heat to help keep these large animals cool, but sometimes the African heat is too much. Elephants are fond of water and enjoy showering by sucking water into their trunks and spraying it all over themselves. Afterwards, they often spray their skin with a protective coating of dust. An elephant's trunk is actually a long nose used for smelling, breathing, trumpeting, drinking, and also for grabbing things, especially a potential meal. The trunk alone contains about 100,000 different muscles. African elephants have two finger-like features on the end of their trunk that they can use to grab small items. Both playful elephants. Both male and female African elephants have tusks they use to dig for food and water and strip bark from trees. Males use the tusks to battle one another. Elephants eat roots, grasses, fruit, and bark, and they eat a lot of these things. An adult elephant can consume up to 300 pounds of food in a single day. These hungry animals do not sleep much, and they roam over great distances while foraging for the large quantities of food that they require to sustain their massive bodies. Female elephants, cows, live in family herds with their young, but adult males, bulls, tend to roam on their own. Having a baby elephant is a serious commitment. Elephants have a longer pregnancy than any other mammal, almost 22 months. Cows usually give birth to one calf every 2 to 4 years. At birth, elephants already weigh some 200 pounds and stand about 3 feet tall. They range throughout sub-Saharan Africa and the rainforests of Central and West Africa. These elephants in Amboseli National Park like to eat in the marshland. This elephant would not let any of the Land Cruisers go by.
Maneuvering himself.
Our driver reminded us that an elephant can turn over a Land Cruiser. Zebra. No animal has a more distinctive coat than the zebra. Each animal's stripes are as unique as fingerprints. No two are exactly alike, although each of the three species has its own general pattern. The patterns may make it difficult for predators to identify a single animal from a running herd and distort distance at dawn and dusk. Zebras are social animals that spend time in herds. They graze together, primarily on grass, and even groom one another. Plains zebras are the most common species. They live in small family groups consisting of a male, several females, and their young. These units may combine with others to form awe-inspiring herds thousands of head strong, but family members will remain close within the herd. Zebras must be constantly wary of lions and hyenas. A herd has many eyes alert to danger. If an animal is attacked, its family will come to its defense, circling the wounded zebra and attempting to drive off predators. There are over 1,000 species of birds in East Africa. We only scratched the surface with the 40-plus birds that we saw in Kenya, Tanzania, and Rwanda. The following videos and pictures are most of the birds we saw. The gray ground crane is about 3.3 feet tall, weighs 7 pounds and 70 pence, and has a wingspan of 6.5 feet. The gray ground crane has a breeding display involving dancing, bowing, and jumping. Dancing is an integral part of courtship, but also may be done at any time of the year.
Yellow-billed stork.
The secretary bird is a very large, mostly terrestrial bird of prey. Endemic to Africa, it is usually found in the open grasslands and savanna of the sub-Saharan region. Prey is often flushed out of tall grass by the birds stomping on the surrounding vegetation.
What kind of birds are those?
Thank you.
pretty one there. So why would they all be out of the water now?
Bones.